Hey, Zach.
What's up?
What are we doing today, buddy?
We're heading to Cooke City, Montana on June 3rd.
June 3rd?
June 3rd.
Going to Cooke City, Montana?
Yeah.
What on earth are you going to be doing in Cooke City, Montana on June 3rd?
We're going to go rock jumping with our sleds. We decided that we wanted new sleds, so we're just going to rock jump them. No parachutes either.
Going to find the biggest hill to find and just rock it out, huh?
That's right.
So what do you got to say about Team Flamers? Team Flamers reunites?
It's my understanding that Flame Master Jay realized how lonely life was not being a flamer anymore. He saw how cool and how big of a celebrity I was, you know, being Flame Master Z, and all the kids that wanted my autographs, and when people just, we'd be out shopping, they'd be like, dude, are you Flame Master Z? I'd be like, that's me, and I mean, just, I think he felt like an outcast that he had to, you know, come back and join the Team Flamers.
The dude from YouTube, right? That's what they keep asking. Yeah, it's like, aren't you the dude from YouTube, Flame Master Z?
Yeah, I get it all the time. It's, I almost had to hire a bodyguard, you know, but.
So, feeling that it was appropriate for Team Flamers to reunite, we had to come up with some new names since, you know, it's kind of a reunite and, you know, a new team name. And we're going to go for, is it Gold Flamer? And Icy Hot.
Icy Hot, yeah.
Gold Flamer and Icy Hot back there in the trailer.
Yeah, we were able to, you know, we had a little bit of a closed door kind of sit down there, hashed out some things because I wasn't just going
to
let.
Well, honestly, we had to re-sign contracts. I mean, that's what it comes down to.
Flame Master Jay just wasn't going to walk back into Team Flamers
without signing some kind of a contract.
Yeah, with thinking, you know, he's going to be instant high status in my
yeah.
My
but in the spirit of James Bond and Goldfinger, we decided to go with Gold Flamer and Icy Hot.
So there was some hand hugging, some tears, some laughter.
There was some bloodshed.
Overall, you know, a few tears, a couple boxes of Kleenexes, and a couple scars. We decided to reunite.
There you go. So we also had a little bit of a side trip we had to make on the way out here. You know, because honestly, did we just decide, like, out of the blue that we were going to drive out here in January or in June and go riding?
Nah, my brother actually bought a sled from Cody Beck out of Utah there. And Cody agreed to meet us in Casper, Wyoming. And my brother, you know, he was willing to pay, you know, for part of the trip, you know, to go get his sled. And so I called John up here and I was like, hey, Flame Master Z is going to Cooke City. I was wondering if Flame Master J was game.
Gold Flamer said, I'm in.
He manned up.
Count me in.
Say. So now we're on our way to Cody, Wyoming.
We got a full load, baby.
Full load.
Look at that full load back there.
That's right.
We got a sled in the back of the truck. We got two sleds in the trailer. We got two studs in the truck.
Yeah.
That's all I got to say, man.
Full load, ready to explode to hit some powder. More like spring snow.
June 4th, 2011. Cooke City, Montana. Zach and I are out snowmobiling, having an awesome time. First day, we're about an hour and a half into our ride. Just lost Zach somewhere. He went up over that hill.
Zach just went up this hill over here.
Went over the top of it, and now he's got a story to tell us. Story time with Zach Hansen. Icy Hot. Look at the camera, buddy.
Well, we all remember what happened in, what was that, 09?
I think so, yep.
When I wrecked my sled in March. Well, I was just telling John back there that, you know, I was just thinking, man, I shot Daisy real high, same thing. And I'm like, man, it just reminded me of 09. I'm like, when I crashed my sled, I don't want to do that. So I shoot up here, and I'm hoping it's on camera because it was a scary ordeal. So I get up top. I shot up in those rocks up there.
Yeah.
And I went to turn around, so I come back down. But my sled wouldn't let me turn.
Uh-oh.
So there's only one chute down. And let me tell you, the chute isn't the nicest chute. It's like this wide. And there's a boulder this big and a little one this big. And I either got to run over it or I got to try to go here. But then There's all trees and rocks, and it's actually, it's like that rock formation there on this side. So it's all rocks on this side down, and then it's all trees, but this side's open. So I ran over the big boulder and the little boulder. Luckily, I don't see any damage to my sled. And the whole time, I'm like this with my foot dragging, hanging on my sled like this, you know, just to slow down because it was deep. And oh my gosh, I come back and I see John went up there, and my heart stopped because I was like, if he followed my path, that's not good.
No, I was gonna, and then I saw you going up further. I'm like, I don't know where their way out is up there, so I'm not going. But I'll tell you, even on this way back, this little hill here that don't look like that big, there's two humps in it, and those humps are like, oh my God. When I come down off that second hump, I almost caught air, and I was trying to slow down with my brakes. So, pretty crazy. Lots of snow, but it's all hard packing, so you just fly, you haul ass down these hills. It's hard to control.
I am gonna be really mad if that thing's on camera, because that gave a perspective and of, wow. Wow, my heart's still pumping.
Why don't we just ride up there if it's so cool?
See all the...
Yeah?
See all that little, like... I came all the way along the street. My phone was making...
We'll be right back.
is awesome, man. June 3rd or 4th?
Don't at the blue flames. My buddy with the blue skidoo. Right there. I could have gotten really hurt.
Yeah. Wow.
Front bumper for sure. Depending on how hard it hit, I don't know if I wrecked the can or the exhaust pipe. Handlebars folded down, but that'll come back up. I think it's still gonna be rideable.
Life's good, dude.
Huh?
Life's good.
Well, then we're good to go.
Wow. How'd that happen?
Well, I got up in there. Just do a tight turn and come down, and I got up there and I couldn't make the tight turn, so I tried to come across thinking there'd be an opening here.
Okay.
And I started coming down, and it was so steep I fucking couldn't, there was no control. So I was heading right for a little tree that I knew would throw me off anyway and get hurt, so I just bailed. And then I slid down over into that tree over there. Okay? That tree right over there. I kind of caught my foot and my ankle on that one a little bit, but I think I'm okay. Huh? I think we can drag it off this side. I just want to get my handlebar risers back up again. I thought I was going to fucking pile into the trees really bad. Like, personally, I thought myself. I was at the point where I was no longer worried about the sled. I was worried about whether I was going to make it. And I knew I was heading right down for these trees, and I was sliding down kind of backwards,
yeah,
foot first, so I couldn't see what was going on. I just knew I was heading right for the trees, so I was bracing for the impact. And when I hit, I'm like, oh, shit, that wasn't that bad. If you want, go ahead. I think I'm still recording mine. Hey, I think mine's still recording. I got the whole thing on tape.
Think of that.
That was awesome, man.